UFC next Sunday. We've got Hugh Morris against Crash in our opening contest. We've got a tremendous hour here. What is Crash doing?
Uh-oh. I question that every single day.
I think he has just dared Hugh Morris to cross the line, which, of course, Hugh Morris does very willingly. And now, well, there certainly is a line been drawn between Stone Cold Steve Austin, Kurt Angle, and Rob Van Dam. It will all go down at No Mercy, triple threat main event for the WWF title. We'll talk more about that later, a little bit later on in the hour as Crash starts off with Hugh Morris here. Reversal now, and Crash sent across, up and over the top. Crash will certainly have the speed advantage against a very powerful Hugh Morris who could surprise you with aerial moves of his own.
You know, KK, we talked about the fact that Stone Cold Steve Austin knew he couldn't beat Kurt Angle straight up, and that didn't happen on Raw. But then comes SmackDown. Stone Cold Steve Austin made it very apparent that it was over. This whole rivalry with Kurt Angle was going to be over. He didn't want to give Kurt Angle another title.
There ain't going to be no rematch.
No, exactly. Well, WWF Commissioner Mick Foley made an end to that very, very quickly. And wasn't it very ironic and very poetic how Mick Foley talked RVD, Rob Van Dam, into accepting his offer to be in that triple threat match at No Mercy?
Power slam, great rotation, only a two count. Of course, a little bit later on in the hour, we'll show you exactly why I think Rob Van Dam very willingly accepted Commissioner Mick Foley's challenge, if you will, to be part of that main event match, and it was Stone Cold's doing.
Well, by the way, it wasn't a very hard sell, by the way, for Mick Foley to get RVD to get in that matchup.
Another cover and another near fall. Hugh Morris pressing the early physical advantage on Crash. As I mentioned, we are going to have some great in-ring action. We'll see Canyon one-on-one against Billy Gunn. Plus, we will also see the APA, Bradshaw Farouk, in the house, taking on Chuck Palumbo and Mike Awesome.
I knew that, as JR would say, business was going to pick up a little bit later.
Oh, wait a minute now. This time, a leg drop, and Hugh Morris scores a near fall. Hugh Morris has tried a variety of moves here, yet to keep Crash down. You know Crash is double tough, though. And what a challenge it's going to be for Stone Cold Steve Austin at No Mercy, Coach, because you think about it. Here is a man in Kurt Angle who Stone Cold Steve Austin could not beat up until this Monday, and a man in Rob Van Dam who Stone Cold Steve Austin has already lost to here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, Rob Van Dam's star is certainly rising, if you will, and in the past few weeks, Rob Van Dam has not only pinned the World Wrestling Federation champion, but also the WCW champion as well. And walk out the World Wrestling Federation champion. Well, you're just not watching the same program we're watching. Because Rob Van Dam could flat out get the job done, and he may indeed walk out the World Wrestling Federation champion and leave Stone Cold Steve Austin and Kurt Angle standing in the middle of the ring. And what would that do to the whole framework of the alliance of RVD with the WWF champion?
You know, it certainly will change the structure of the alliance, I think, and the future of the World Wrestling Federation definitely did change this week. We knew that was going to happen. It had to. Something had to give with Angle and Stone Cold Steve Austin, but who would have ever guessed that Commissioner William Regal would be the one to change WWF history? And then, of course, Commissioner Mick Foley coming back into power once again, the commissioner here in the World Wrestling Federation.
That I am particularly happy about.
Oh, yeah, it's a good thing.
Life was good when Mick Foley was here.
Hugh Morris is going to go for the no laughing matter, the moonsault, but wait a minute, Crash back on his feet. Oh, no, Hugh Morris pays for the high rent district.
I thought for a second there you were talking about the Florida State Seminoles.
Easy now.
Ah, sorry, kid.
They all can't be winning years. They can't win the national title every year. Tornado DDT isn't enough.
Oh,
no, it's not. Crash thought he had it.
You know, Crash has really put on quite a show against Hugh Morris. Obviously, the size difference between the two, but you can't measure the heart.
No, it's kind of like the Hurricane with Kane.
Title. Hugh Morris scores a victory.
he's depressing me. Why? Each and every day.
Just because Tajiri is right there holding Tori's hand, getting her orange juice.
All right, you're going to call
getting her some aspirins.
I'm going to go get myself an aspirin.
Rubbing her feet. You know any Japanese yet, Coach? Those
no.
language tapes in your truck, I didn't understand. Now I got it.
Well, you know, well, yeah, it's not working.
Why not?
Well, it's Russian. You know,
oh,
it's
yeah, you know, I know you got a good deal, probably,
well, you
right?
Know, you know me, I'm always trying to save a buck.
Yeah, after the lock of the week again didn't come through for the coach. Billy Gunn ringing up the left arm, getting taken down by Canyon, who, of course, is a very innovative specialist, I guess you could say, known for unique moves, high-risk offense. Billy Gunn, a tag team specialist, to say the least, but has really carved his niche here as a single star. It's going to be a very even contest. Big shoulder block puts Canyon down. Cannot wait to see what's going to happen at No Mercy. It is going to be wild. A little bit later on, we'll show you the return of Commissioner Mick Foley into power and how Mick's first decision, how Mick's really influenced shaping the main event for No Mercy.
You know, a lot of people can say what they want about Mick Foley and the job he did as WWF Commissioner. Some people loved him. Some people didn't like him so much. But the bottom line is, when Mick Foley is in power, Mick Foley gets things done. And did you see on SmackDown how quickly things started to develop for No Mercy? How quickly things started to come together, not just in that triple threat match that Mick Foley made, but throughout the entire card.
Oh,
and when you look, oh my goodness.
Oh, oh my goodness. Canyon, no small man at 245 pounds.
Wow.
Really making it look easy. Here's a cover after the gorilla press, and somehow Canyon kicks out.
But KK, if you look at the entire card from top to bottom, and we'll talk about them, you know, there really isn't a match on there that I don't want to see.
Oh, Edge and Christian in a ladder match for the Intercontinental title. You're also going to see The Rock against Chris Jericho for the WCW Championship. And who would have guessed, Coach, a week ago that we'd be saying that these two men can't wait to get at each other? Wait a minute. Here is a cover, too. Almost got him.
And make no mistake about it, this Rock and Y2J Chris Jericho match is not going to be a friendly competition in the ring. Both of these men have huge egos.
Oh, yeah.
There's a lot of pride on the line, and oh, by the way, WCW titles up for grabs as well.
Yeah, but you know what? That's a championship that I'm sure Jericho would love to earn. Because Jericho was in WCW at one time. Never even got a sniff of that WCW championship while he was there. And, you know, Jericho critics, Shane McMahon, one of the, wait a minute, beautiful,
Northern Lights of the Bridge.
Almost got him. Jericho critics, Shane McMahon, hit the nail right on the head.
He did.
Jericho
he did.
Has never won the big one. He is a choke artist. That's what Jericho critics will say. And, of course, Jericho needs to win this big one. He needs to win at No Mercy.
You think you'd have to compare Chris Jericho to the likes of maybe the Buffalo Bills, if you will. A person, a superstar, who has reached the top of the mountain, who has become a big-time player, but like you said, has never been able to get over that hump.
It's
to get all the way to the top of the mountain. That could happen next Sunday at No Mercy.
It's always great to be in the main event, but nobody ever remembers who came in second.
Exactly.
So it will be Jericho and Rock for the WCW Championship, a bitter rivalry that has blossomed seemingly overnight. We'll have the highlights of that coming up in just a few moments. Billy Gunn and Canyon have been going toe-to-toe. This has been a war here, and now we'll see what happens. Gunn drops a hard right hand. Hit another one.
You know, these are two guys that are ultra-talented, and even though physically they don't look the same, they can get just the same job done inside that ring.
Almost got him. You saying Canyon doesn't have a good body?
I'm saying it.
Are you saying Canyon's looking flabby?
I'm not saying that at all. Don't put words in my mouth. Please don't put words in my mouth. I'm saying that Billy Gunn is always in excellent shape.
Oh, yeah.
And Canyon's in good shape as well, but Billy Gunn is just ripped up.
Yeah, I mean, very few people on this planet will look as good as Billy Gunn. Wait a minute. Going for the I'm better than you. The finishing move from Canyon. Gunn counters. Now, locks up the wall. Only Gunn. This one will be over.
What a great reversal.
Score a victory for the WWF. No! I spoke too soon. Canyon kicks out.
Well, this matchup has been tremendous, and it continues to be. I thought it was over right there, but Canyon has a little bit left. How much? I don't know.
Now Billy Gunn sending Canyon across. Wait a minute, Billy. Oh, his head. Great Russian leg sweep. The float over. Is it enough? Oh!
You know, whichever man wins this matchup, KK, will be a huge mark for him, a huge match for him, because both of these guys need huge wins against big time superstars like each other.
And now is the famouser. Got him.
Big win for Billy Gunn, KK.
Here is your winner, the one, Billy Gunn.
Billy Gunn had it in his head. Canyon made him pay for it. Gunn kicked out. Canyon tucked his head. Billy Gunn made him pay for it and scored the victory. Still to come here on Metal. It's Steven Richards' return pounds of metal. Hear the excitement in my voice, and unfortunately for Steven, he'll take on Albert.
Yeah, but up next, highlights of that classic match, Jericho, RVD from SmackDown.
What a welcome back for Billy Kidman. His first match back in active competition, and he takes the WCW Cruiserweight crown away from X-Pac.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall. Entering the ring, representing the Alliance, weighing 236 pounds, Steven Ritter.
Well, other than his bag being about 12 pounds lighter, what do you think X-Pac is going to do now that he only has one title?
Well, X-Pac certainly is one guy I don't feel sorry for.
Tomorrow on MTV, the house is going to be rocking at WWF New York. Of course, we're there at MSG, 2 p.m. start time for a big live event. And then the After Garden party, you'll be able to see The Rock, Stone Cold Steve Austin, Kurt Angle, The Undertaker, and more. A star-studded event at WWF New York. Now, I'm wondering, Coach, how are Edge and Christian going to settle things?
You know, I was also talking about settling things. I'm interested to see how The Rock and Y2 and Jer are going to settle things now. And you got to believe that somehow, some way, Stephanie McMahon Helmsley and Shane McMahon are looking forward to this matchup because Stephanie's been trying for, it seems like, forever to get Y2J out of the World Wrestling Federation, to end Y2J once and for all. And it doesn't seem like anybody in the Alliance can get the job done. So maybe, right in his own backyard, The Rock's going to get the job done for the McMahons in a roundabout way.
Steven went inside instead of outside the ring.
Oh,
but I know, and how ironic with Shane trying to take down The Rock, derail his WCW championship hopes and dreams and aspirations along the way. So now it's going to be Rock against Jericho at No Mercy for that WCW title. And like you say, Coach, Shane and Stephanie McMahon are going to have to be loving every second of this one. Well, Steven Richards, with just things look their most bleak, now Richards getting on the offense.
You know, when you talk about the whole Stone Cold Steve Austin situation and the fact that Stone Cold is the new WWF champion. A week ago, I probably would have said, KK, that if Stone Cold indeed can beat Kurt Angle on Raw, then that would be the best thing for the Alliance. But after what happened this past week on Raw and SmackDown, Stone Cold winning that title the way that he did with the turncoat William Regal coming over to the Alliance, that may have been the worst thing that could have happened to the Alliance. Because now Mick Foley is back, and life for Stone Cold as the WWF champion, I don't think, is going to be an easy one.
Well, we have Linda right under the jaw. We have Linda McMahon to thank for the return of Commissioner
Mick
Foley.
Thank you, Linda. I know she's listening and watching.
Linda, as always, comes through for the fans of the World Wrestling Federation. Seems like every time Linda is on TV, something big happens, and that certainly happened on SmackDown. Uh-oh. Steven Richards in the clutches.
Maybe it's finally over for Steven Richards.
We could only against Mike Awesome and Chuck Palumbo.
Yeah, but up next, Stone Cold plotted for weeks to get the WWF title back. But was it worth it? We're coming back.
It's me, DDP. And I have a very special message for a very special person. Kurt Angle. You know, Kurt, you're losing the WWF Championship to Stone Cold Steve Austin on Raw. It wasn't a bad thing. It was a good thing. Why? Because, Kurt, you learned a valuable lesson. You learned that sometimes you have to lose things to realize just how valuable they really are. And now that you've lost the WWF Championship, you realize that nothing is more important to you than that. And when you're not the WWF champion, you feel like a nobody, a nothing, a loser. But Kurt, you're not a nobody. You're a somebody. And even if you're not the WWF champion, people still like you. I mean, I like you. I know you like me. And I just helped you like you.
Give props out to the new WCW Tag Team Champions. The Hardy Boys got a victory over Booker T and Test. A little help from a friend.
Well, certainly Booker T and Test would say that the Undertaker interfering was not the way the Hardy Boys should have won the tag team titles. However, if you remember how Booker T and Test won those tag team titles, then they can't be barking at all, if you will.
Ooh.
Oh, my goodness. Just kicking him like a...
What does JR say? Running mule?
Scalded dog?
Yeah, something like that. Same thing.
Some afflicted animal.
Yeah, exactly. But, you know, the Hardy Boys, nonetheless, are the WCW Tag Team Champions. Booker T and Tess were not pleased at all. So now Booker T challenges The Undertaker. Of course, The Undertaker gladly accepts for no mercy. But now Tess must face
Kane as well. I don't know if Booker T and Tess realize what they're getting into one-on-one.
Yeah, with Kane taking on Tess and The Undertaker challenging Booker T, it's going to be a very interesting night at No Mercy. Those are just two of the great matches that we're going to see next Sunday on pay-per-view. Palumbo, head of steam, into the corner, running right into the awaiting arms of Bradshaw.
A little power display for you, Coach.
You know, the telegraph machine was invented like 50 years ago, Chuck.
50 years ago?
Maybe longer than that.
You're up on your history.
Yeah, exactly. Well, it wasn't exactly my best subject in school.
Do they have schools in McPherson, Kansas?
Easy!
They have one school. K through 12. Yeah,
well, that's where I went. A lot of people know where McPherson, Kansas is.
Oh! Sure they do. That's where all the UFOs go.
Enough.
Well, Chuck Palumbo has done his best to fight off Bradshaw, now making the tag final. Mike Awesome. Welcome, Mike, to the match. By the way, it's been a great tag team encounter. Your partner's been doing a fine job.
Don't be scared to come in and join the fray.
Don't be scared to come get you some. Break off a little piece of something right here.
Say, say.
Uh-oh, Bradshaw missing the clothesline. Awesome, head of steam. One of the best things that Mike Awesome does. He's so explosive.
Well, we talk about how great of athlete. Wait a second.
Here is a cover. Farouk looking on.
You know, you talk about Mike Awesome and Chuck Palumbo. Physically, they are tremendously well put together. And they can certainly match up physically with the APA. But they need to be aggressive. As we did, as Spike Dudley went through that table.
Yeah, Dudley boys. Spike Dudley was literally launched. Wait a minute now, here is another cover. Spike Dudley was literally launched out of the ring through a table on SmackDown. Spike suffered a concussion and severely bruised ribs, and we understand that Spike is out indefinitely. The Dudleys certainly had a very destructive week, and if the APA got an opportunity to get their hands on the Dudley boys and another opportunity at the WWF Tag Team titles, I think that would be just fine.
Well, Mike Awesome takes way too long when he gets to the top rope. Physically, he can get up there. Certainly, he can get the job done when he's up there and comes down, but you just can't wait that long when you got a Farouk waiting on you in the ring.
Uh-oh, Farouk got himself in a bad spot in the ring. That's a rare mistake from a veteran. Palumbo makes him pay for it, and now the DDT. Tag is made. Here comes Chuck Palumbo. And can this team of Chuck Palumbo and Mike Awesome, despite the fact that they've never teamed up before, but they have very infrequently, giving up a tremendous amount of experience to the APA, can they pull off what would be a huge upset?
I think right now the alliance is trying to figure out what guys they can put together, what is actually going to work in order to make strides here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Oh, man, Bradshaw's in. Uh-oh.
Oh, my God.
Palumbo's starting to get a little hot.
Well, I think the ice is melting backstage. Oh, they want to get back there.
Yeah, they got to keep the suds nice and cold.
That's it. Chilling.
You ever lost any card games to the APA?
No, I usually go in there knowing that I'm going to lose.
So you just hand
it. Even if I win, I lose.
Well, there you see the spine buster from Farouk. And now he needs to make a tag. Bradshaw, fresh in the corner, ready to go. Referee Charles Robinson applying the count.
Well, both of these men need a tag in the worst way, KK.
Palumbo tags Awesome in first. So wait a minute now. Bradshaw's tagged in far side. Here we go. Mike Awesome takes the bottom of Bradshaw's boot. Awesome set across.
Somebody must have buzzed Bradshaw on the fact the ice is starting to melt. Because he's taking on both guys. He said, Brook, if you don't want to help me, that's cool.
They have radar for that type of thing.
Exactly.
You just know. Off the neck breakers. Wait a minute. Now Palumbo is in. Farouk is in.
Yeah, now I think Farouk got buzzed as well.
It's breaking down in Tulsa. Look out. Awesome. It's in a cold.
Oh, no.
The APA is happy hour.
Think we can go 3 minutes?
No.
Come on, kid. Let's have it.
No. We got no shot.
And he is safe.
He answered, and it's live this Sunday only on pay-per-view.
Well, I think Raven and Justin Credible, they have scored a quick win here over Funaki.
Rocky. No, he kicks out at two. Terry bouncing along with the action inside the ring. And I know, of course, that this Sunday we're going to see Stone Cold Steve Austin, who after this week, we know he's a paranoid champion. But after what happened on SmackDown, Coach, Austin has to be more paranoid than ever.
Well, certainly Stone Cold felt like he was going to go in with RVD on his side. But now RVD, maybe with this McMahon, maybe on his. Oh, my goodness. But Kurt Angle certainly wants to win that World Wrestling Federation title back. And Stone Cold Steve Austin could not be more paranoid than he is right now, because we all know that he doesn't feel like he can beat Kurt Angle by himself. But now what do you do when you got RVD, who is absolutely a shooting star right now, in that matchup as well?
Raven and Justin Credible are doing a very effective job of isolating Funaki. Raven, completely reckless, no regard for his own well-being at all. And now, the sunset flip attempt. Oh. Wait a minute, Tuck is in to break it up. One, two, almost had him.
You know, you talk about Justin Credible and Raven. Of course, on SmackDown, they were set to take on Rock and Chris Jericho. Mick Foley was trying to make some peace before this huge matchup between Y2J and The Rocket at No Mercy. But that didn't exactly happen. And Justin Credible and Raven just ended up being bystanders.
Yeah, they certainly did. And I know that Chris Jericho's got that choke artist label on him. He wants to shake that label this Sunday. The WCW Championship on the line. This is the big one that Jericho needs to win. He is not going to be good. He's not going to go down in history like the 86 Red Sox. He wants to be a winner. He wants to be a champion. Tag is made. Taka's in. Letting both Raven and Justin Credible have
it. Oh, what about the Buffalo Bills? You make it to the big show four times, you can never win the big one. Jericho said it when he was in the WCW. Never won the big one. Certainly since he's been here in the World Wrestling Federation, never won the big one. So this Sunday, would it be apropos to say this is the biggest match of Chris Jericho's career?
I think you can say that without argument at all. And now the double team advantage. But
wait a second. Incredible, everything they want. And speaking of giving somebody everything they want,
oh!
Superstars, employees, and most importantly, the fans worldwide in the World Wrestling Federation, to present to the Honorable Rudy Giuliani a check in the amount of $1 million to the $10,000 fund. We hope that it will somehow, it won't compensate for anyone's personal loss. But we hope that it will be helpful.
You know, it really will help. It will help a great deal, because the most you can do for a family to help them is to say, well, they'll be financially secure. And this will help a lot of firefighters and police officers' families be financially secure.
Well,
and it helps them to recover.
I wanted an opportunity to say hello to the mayor himself, because we think he's been such an incredible stalwart during all of this and really has been the glue that has moved all of this forward. So it was a pleasure to meet him, present the check personally, and he was very gracious. Thank you personally for being the kind of guy that we've had here in New York during this time.
And your restaurant is a great addition.
Thank you.
to Times Square.
We've been happy to be able to give back a little bit in such a tragic situation, but we wanted to say we care and we're here.
New York City and all the people in it, we smell what you're cooking.
So many heroes have been written as of the tragedy of September 11th, and I'll tell you what, it felt so good to be able to contribute in some small way to those funds and to help out the firefighters, the policemen, and their families. And I know that, of course, on behalf of all the fans and superstars, we're happy to be there in front of Rudy Giuliani, who is a hero in our own right. The mayor of New York City has been tremendous, and I know will continue to be an enduring figure as they rebuild New York City. Association's Team Read Week this past week. Stacy Keebler, Hurricane Helm.
Mighty Molly, read Mick Foley's new book, Halloween Hijinks, and Maria Shriver's new book, What's Wrong with Timmy? A question I ask myself every week. They were at libraries in the New York area this past Wednesday. For more details, check out WWF.com. A lot of questions to be answered going into this Sunday, Coach.
What role will Mr. McMahon play on Sunday at No Mercy? Can Chris Jericho win the big one? What about the Intercontinental title match, Edge versus Christian, which has gone way beyond personal?
Yeah.
This is just getting, it's just getting ridiculous.
Well, Christian, of course, is the newest recruit of the Alliance, the newest Alliance member, Christian. He'll walk in with that Intercontinental title, and at No Mercy this Sunday, they'll put that Intercontinental Championship belt high above the ring. The first man, either Edge or Christian, who can set up a ladder, climb up there, and take control of the gold will be the Intercontinental Champion. And I'll tell you what, as a fan of the World Wrestling Federation, and as a fan of human decency, I certainly hope that it is Edge, because what Christian did this past week crossed any line that has ever been drawn before.
You just don't use a family member saying they were in a serious accident, you gotta get into the hospital. That's just something you don't do. You don't do it, especially when it's your own mom.
That's right.
You can't do that.
There's such a thing as karma, and karmatic debt right now, very heavily owed by Christian. As Mike Awesome misses a clothesline here, though, trying to show his power, but it's not too hot. He's been one step ahead of Awesome so far.
You know, KK, when you talk about being on a roll, when you talk about the power and the shifting of power, and you look at the Alliance and the new recruits that the Alliance has, you talk about Christian. Certainly, Chris has been a welcome recruit, but now you've got new Alliance Commissioner William Regal. You've got to admit, call a spade a spade, call it what you will, but the Alliance right now, it seems like to me, is on a roll.
And I'll take it one step further than that. I don't see the World Wrestling Federation going out there and trying to recruit any Alliance guys.
No.
Or are they?
Well, that's a very, very good point.
Because we've seen Mr. McMahon, Thursday on SmackDown, return to World Wrestling Federation programming quite some time. There's Mike Awesome with some elevation.
He is so athletic.
To count only.
Yeah, but at the same time, there's so many lowlifes in the Alliance. I wouldn't want to go out and recruit a lot of them, but however, there are a few that I wouldn't mind having in the World Wrestling Federation. And Mr. McMahon, say what you want about the man, has never been a stupid businessman. He always does what's good for business.
Business,
you know what I'm saying? And having RVD in his corner is good for business.
Well, we'll see what happens at No Mercy. We don't know what role Mr. McMahon is going to play. And, you know, we still don't know what Mr. McMahon and RVD talked about in that limousine. I would have loved to have been a fly on the wall for that conversation.
I doubt that Rob Van Dam is stupid enough to tell Stone Cold everything they talked about. I mean, he said, oh, Mr. McMahon said the same thing that you told me. Reach the stars, I could be a champion, da-da-da-da. But did he tell him everything? I did.
There for Mike Awesome. So athletic, as you mentioned, Coach. And Mike Awesome gets a two count, is beginning to wear down Scotty Too Hotty. Scotty moved. He used his agility very well, but now the power and agility combination could be too much. Here comes the running Awesome Bomb. No, wait a minute. Scotty slides off the shoulder. Awesome misses with a clothesline. Head of steam. And now...
Is that the pie face worm? Is that what we call it?
The inverted bulldog? Like the pie face. We'll call it the pie face. Surprise that one was. Scotty now trying to figure out what he can do next to Mike Awesome.
You know, Mike Awesome usually has that far out spacey look in his head, but right now I think it's justified.
Yes. Well, Scotty Too Hotty pounding away in the dullest part of Mike Awesome. That, of course, is his head. Now Scotty going to the top rope. The test, it better not look past Billy Gunn.
Yeah, but up next, Jericho steps it up. But is it enough to defeat the Rock and No Mercy?
Sunday at No Mercy.
You know, KK, right now I got a challenge for all the fans of St. Louis. I know they see us there in St. Louis, and this past week we were in Ottawa for Raw, SmackDown, we were in Montreal, the crowds were off the charts. My challenge to the fans of St. Louis is, can they be that good this Sunday at No Mercy? That's the question. They're great fans, but can they be that good?
I don't think it's a question of if. I think it's a question of when will they get that loud, and that's going to be this Sunday, because St. Louis fans are great. Kansas City Monday for Raw.
Yep. Respecting him, and maybe he can get a little bit of that respect back if he can defeat The Undertaker at No Mercy.
Booker T seems to be one of those guys that no matter how much respect he will earn, he will never feel like he gets respect. That seems to be where he gets his inner strength from, where he draws from.
Right.
And that's cool. But I know that The Undertaker will give you respect if you earn it. And Booker T certainly has a great chance to earn everybody's respect this Sunday at No Mercy.
Yeah, we ordered it. Order it right now. Call your local cable operator or satellite provider. Remember, it's not going to be available on DirecTV this weekend, so you need to find another way to get it on pay-per-view.
Whoa, wait a minute. Quick cover there from Billy Gunn. Just a one count.
The easiest way, KK, is just go to WWF.com. They'll give you all the details on how to order No Mercy Live this Sunday.
Ripping left hands there from Billy Gunn. Test certainly with his mind focused on Kane at No Mercy, and you know that Chris Jericho has his mind focused on The Rock. Billy Gunn scores with the big splash in the corner, and now head of steam, big clothesline. Here's the cover coming up. Wait a minute, referee Teddy Long in position, two count only. We saw moments ago what happened with Jericho and The Rock. We knew that there was volatility, but I think it even exceeded all of our expectations.
Oh, yeah, when you talk about it, certainly The Rock and Chris Jericho have not been enemies in the past, but when you have such a big Jericho, who was trying to make a career out of this one night, when Chris Jericho is trying to make everybody forget about everything else he has done and look at him as a champion, then friendships get thrown out the window. Rivalries start to grow because their egos will not allow them right now to like each other. The Rock certainly doesn't want to be embarrassed at No Mercy, and that's not going to happen. Jericho doesn't want to be embarrassed, and that's not going
to
happen.
Well, think about it as well. Jericho wants to erase the stigma of not being able to win the big one. Rock doesn't want to be the guy who lost the big one to the guy who couldn't win the big one. So there's a lot of pressure on both guys as we head into No Mercy this Sunday. The physical pressure being put on Billy Gunn right now from Test, who I think has really been an MVP for the Alliance since defecting from the WWF. Here's
I would
cover.
Agree with that.
Two count only.
You know, you talk about the big one. Not to divert from The Rock and Chris Jericho. We'll get back to that in a second. But when you talk about the big one, the match I'm looking forward to, mano a mano. You talk about egos, pride on the line. You got to talk about the triple threat
match?
No. I like where you're going with that, though.
Yeah.
But I was talking about the
ladder match. Edge and Christian for the Intercontinental Championship.
No. I like where you're going with that one, too. But I'm talking history in the making. History's going to be made this Sunday.
Yeah, when the WWF Tag Team titles are on the line. The Dudley Boys defend against the Big Show and Tajiri.
No. Not that one, either. But the matchup I'm talking about.
The WCW Tag Team titles.
No. But we're close to the same page, kid. Close to the same page.
Testing
Kane. I'm talking about the first ever lingerie match.
Oh.
Tori Wilson on one side, Stacy Keibler on the other side. What could happen? You know, everybody keeps asking me, Coach, what are the rules in this lingerie match?
I have one answer.
Who cares what the rules are in this lingerie match? It doesn't matter what the rules are.
Coach's lock of the week, the lingerie match is going to be entertaining.
Everybody is going to be a winner.
Now, Test, boy, he and Billy Gunn have really been going at it. This has been a tremendous physical contest. Billy Gunn counters the tilt-a-whirl. Now, Test, wait a minute.
Oh, no!
Runs into a tilt-a-whirl of his own. Now, the leg is hurt. He almost had him.
I tell you what, if Billy Gunn wins this matchup right here, this will certainly hamper, in my opinion, the confidence of Test heading into No Mercy and taking on Kane.
We'll have highlights from everything surrounding the triple threat situation. The World Wrestling Federation Championship on the line this Sunday. Coming up,
boys. WCW titles on the line later.
Yeah, but coming up, what message did RVD try to send to Stone Cold in this cross spot? Hot!
Yeah! Who better than Kane?
Well, then from there, of course, the APA not only won the physical battle on Raw, but then they stole the Hurricycle on SmackDown.
You know, and they're going to drive the Hurricycle, so they say, to St. Louis for no mercy. How cool would it be to ride cross-country with the APA, go to all those establishments?
Yes.
You know, but wouldn't, if you added a couple scenes for you and I, wouldn't it be like a Hurricanebill now?
And wouldn't that defeat the whole purpose?
Exactly. However, it'd still be fun to hang with the acolytes of the APA.
It certainly would be great.
Oh, my goodness, would it ever.
Well, we know, of course, that the team of Canyon and Hugh Morris have a tremendous opportunity with the man. Tremendous.
As always.
As always. And the team of Canyon and Hugh Morris would love to seize WCW gold on behalf of the Alliance. Listen to this crowd chant for Lita.
Well, we talked about the tune-up that Tess had earlier and getting ready for his matchup at No Mercy. This is a tremendous tune-up for the Hardy Boys because they have to put their WCW tag team titles on the line.
That's right. And, of course, Canyon has had made overtures towards Lita in weeks past. Don't know where that whole situation stands. I know Matt Hardy would like nothing more than to get in and slap the taste out of Canyon's mouth.
Well, I think Matt Hardy is almost finding this comical. And this isn't very comical, though, that Canyon wants to face him first instead of Jeff Hardy.
You know, you raised a very good point earlier on, Coach, when you said that Stone Cold Steve Austin does not have to be pinned in order to lose the World Wrestling Federation Championship this Sunday at No Mercy in the Triple Threat match. So is Stone Cold Steve Austin really the target here? I mean, is he the one who is in a great deal of jeopardy?
Oh, well, you would have to think so. I mean, let's say Stone Cold did have to be pinned. I still would think that Stone Cold would be the underdog in this matchup because Kurt Angle wants that title back. RVD doesn't seem to care if he's in the alliance or not. Vince McMahon obviously is RVD's new backstage man, or we don't know what's going to happen. I don't know. The fact that Stone Cold does not have to be pinned, I don't think there's any way that Stone Cold can walk out of No Mercy as the World Wrestling Federation champion.
There's so much drama and intrigue when it comes to the World Wrestling Federation Championship. It's the biggest prize in sports entertainment. Kurt Angle wants nothing more than to get that title back around his waist. Wait a minute, now with the Russian leg sweep. Matt Hardy scores a two and almost three. Boy, oh boy, the champions nearly regained their titles, retained their titles in very quick order. Well, we know, of course, that RVD would love to get a taste of that. Love to get a taste of that gold. He doesn't want to wait 3 to 5 years like Austin told him.
Exactly. And RVD, you know, let's call a spade like we always do. RVD is a star right now. RVD, it would not surprise me if he walked out of No Mercy as a World Wrestling Federation champion. But what does this mean for Shane and Stephanie, who have worked so hard the past few months to build what they have in the alliance? Just to see maybe all of it go by the wayside, have Stone Cold Steve Austin no longer the WWF champion, and possibly no longer have RVD.
Well, it's a tenuous coalition at best, at times, depending on the paranoid moves of Stone Cold.
Oh.
Hugh Morris, great rotation, power slam, cover two, almost had Jeff Hardy beaten. And we know, of course, that you know that Shane and Stephanie have worked very hard to keep this alliance together. Stone Cold Steve Austin is the World Wrestling Federation champion. You know he should be very happy, but the paranoid champion has to be more paranoid than ever after RVD frog splashed him Thursday on SmackDown.
It's hard to feel confident being the World Wrestling Federation champion and being Stone Cold Steve Austin when you know so many things are not in your corner. I mean, how can you feel confident and happy when you're the champion when you know that in just really days and hours, you may no longer be champion and you may no longer be on top of this business?
No poetry in motion there for Hugh Morris, who got caught running around the ring. The blind tag, Matt Hardy, the legal man, blind drop off the second rope. Matt and Jeff Hardy showing why they are the WCW tag team champions. And now Canyon's coming in. Wait a minute now. Twist of fate. No, sir. Oh, man.
I'll tell you what, KK. Hugh Morris and Canyon are They're giving the Hardy Boys everything they can handle and more.
Well, Canyon, we know, is very innovative as far as offense is concerned, and Hugh Morris has worked on his conditioning. The guy's dropped about 20 pounds. He's bigger across the shoulders and across the chest. He looks great. Now the clothesline. Cover two almost had him, and we know, of course, Hugh Morris also aerial expertise, a prominence with Hugh Morris. Surprising for a guy his size, and he's fixing a show right now.
Yeah, well, Hugh Morris has had an eventful week, helping out Christian as one of his new buddies in the Alliance, and a couple of times this week.
What a jerk that Christian is. Man, I would love nothing more. Oh, no laughing matter. I'd love nothing more than to see Edge walk out of No Mercy as the Intercontinental Champion. Now both men are down. Matt Hardy tags Jeff Canyon, tagged in far side. Here we go. Jeff Hardy, Canyon, illegal man. Jeff Hardy now building up some momentum.
I tell you, how much energy are the Hardy Boys having to put forth here on metal? Literally, they've got a huge matchup coming up at No Mercy against the Hurricane and Lance Storm. But they're being taken to the limit and beyond by Canyon and Hugh Morris.
Right in the lower abdomen, and the Hardy Boys love nothing more than that challenge. Put it on the line. They love the adrenaline rush of competition, and Hugh Morris making Jeff Hardy pay for wanting to go on up to the top floor.
Wait a second, KK.
Look at this. Oh, my goodness. Northern Lights.
New champion.
With the bridge. New champions. No. Matt Hardy broke it up at the absolute last moment possible.
You talk about changing the card of No Mercy. It almost happened right there.
It would be Canyon and Hugh Morris who would take on the Hurricane. Oh, wait a minute now. Going for the poetry motion. Roll up two. Got him. No, he didn't. Great scouting by Canyon and Hugh Morris. Came with an eyelash and winning the goal. Now the power of Hugh Morris out of the
no.
Floor. Jeff Hardy. Look out. History-making event as Funaki gets set to go one-on-one here with Chavo Guerrero Jr. Center of the ring, standing side headlock, and now some of the very quick wrestling ability displayed by Chavo Guerrero Jr.
You know, you talk about No Mercy, great night, great event, but then after Raw and SmackDown, we've got to move straight forward now, KK. We got to move straight forward to Survivor Series. Now, you ask all those questions off the top of the show. How can we answer them all? Survivor Series is always history-making. But this year, it's going to be even more so than that. It's all on the line. It's all or nothing. Somebody, someone, the WWF or the Alliance is going to leave town, and they're going to be out of, as we like to say back home, business.
You got to wonder who's nervous going into this one. Certainly after everything that happened on Raw Monday, things not looking good for the Alliance. But a little bit of house cleaning, a little bit of maintenance. Thursday on SmackDown, nice dropkick by Funaki. I mean, hey, listen, Mr. McMahon laid it all on the line. Said, we're done with this Alliance crap. He's been sitting back watching. He's had enough of it. Put it all on the line. Winner take all, one way or another, this invasion is going to end.
Yeah, and he knew that Shane McMahon is a lot like him. He knew that his son is a lot like him. So he knew if you lay a challenge out on the table, no McMahon is going to just leave it on the table. No McMahon is going to say, no, 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 I don't think so. So he knew that Shane McMahon would accept that challenge. And not only that, but Vince McMahon, he wants to get his hands on Shane McMahon this coming Monday on Raw. He wants a piece of his son. Maybe just weeks before, his son, dare I say, comes back and begs for a job.
Listen, the kids have a lot of skills. They're Ivy League educated. You know, I'm sure their resumes will look very good, and I would love to see that application process. I'd love to be there for the interview. Ooh, as Chavo Guerrero Jr. has focused his attack on the back of Funaki and has done a very nice job. That's going to keep Funaki grounded. Now look at this. Up and down. Oh, a backbreaker applied. And as you can see, Chavo competing in a very smart match. Floats over. Two, almost had him.
I would love to be there for the interview process too. I mean, well, let's say, for instance, Vince is like, so Shane, what are your qualifications?
Well, I was the leader of the Alliance, and I was the owner of WCW.
And I'm a backstabbing jerk, and I don't like my father, and I tried
now,
to put my father out of business.
Don't put words in my mouth, Dad. I mean, Vince. I mean, Mr. McMahon.
See?
Sir.
How entertaining could that be?
It would be fantastic. Well, unlike Lou Piniella guaranteeing that the ALCS was going to head back to Seattle.
Hey, the Mariners did go back to Seattle.
But unfortunately, the Yankees didn't go with them.
No.
Well, I know that, you know, unlike the coach's lock of the week, by the way, make sure you let me know who you're voting for in this thing, whether it's the WWF or the Alliance.
What?
I'll be sure to pick the opposite.
What?
Funaki with a hard right hand drops down Chavo. Funaki's been weakened, though, by a very smart offensive attack. Reverse now, it's shot in. Funaki follows in with the forearm.
You know, you can actually, the way Funaki wears his shirt, you can almost see his midriff. Do you know who I was imitating there?
No, who?
Chris Leary. But I digress with that comment. Oh!
A man like Leary would notice a midriff. Wait a minute now. The leg is hooked in a two count, scored by Funaki. But unfortunately, it takes three to win a match. And three is what it will take in Survivor Series to end this invasion one way or another. One match, winner take all. It's all on the line in Survivor Series.
But is that what it's going to be? I mean, we'll talk about that. Oh, wait a second.
Wait a minute. And it looked there as if Funaki pulled Chavo too far.
You know, KK, we don't know at this point exactly how it's going to go down. We'll talk about that a little bit later on in the hour. Exactly what are the stipulations going to be? What kind of match or matches are they going to be? We'll talk about that a little bit later.
Goes for the tornado DDT out of the corner, does Funaki. Misses. Great counter by Chavo on his feet. Now sets up. Center of the ring. There's the brain buster.
Wow, impressive.
And he got him. Chavo Guerrero pays dividends with a very smart offensive attack. Scores the victory for Chavo on behalf of the Alliance. And right now, with all the latest, here's Chris Leary. We're back on metal. Lance Storm getting set to take on Crash in one-on-one action. With so much on the line for the Alliance and the WWF right around the corner in Survivor Series.
From Calgary, Canada, weighing 230 pounds, Lance Storm.
Tell you what, Coach, this is one guy that I would love to have in the World Wrestling Federation. If the Alliance world crumbles and everybody loses their job, which could very well happen in Survivor Series, I wouldn't mind picking up Lance Storm.
Yeah,
and a few others.
Yeah, Lance Storm always brings it to the table.
A lot of speculation now as to what kind of match is going to take place at Survivor Series. It's winner take all. It's all on the line. You can't put the stakes out anymore than Vince McMahon and Shane McMahon did this past week.
Yeah, there's no doubt that careers will change, lives will change after Survivor Series. You know, when this whole invasion thing started, we said the same for Shane and Stephanie, that Shane and Stephanie were giving their guys, their men, and their superstars in the Alliance an opportunity. Well, that opportunity is now all laid out on the table. Shane and Stephanie are going to have to say to all of their men, all their superstars, that, hey, you've got to bring it to the table one night. Because if we don't bring it to the table this night, we're out of jobs. There is no more Alliance. Ooh. And Stone Cold Steve Austin needs to be that leader and was that leader on SmackDown. But you got to wonder, you know, depending on the matchup at Survivor Series, depending on the matchup and how the stipulations are laid out, that's really going to determine who has the advantage at Survivor Series.
You really said it right when you said before the careers and lives are going to change after Survivor Series, because this whole confrontation between the Alliance and the WWF will come to a conclusion at Survivor Series. Crash has moved very effectively so far against Landstorm, but there you see, so technically sound. Great ring presence at all times. Landstorm, a premier technician, really knows how to get it done.
You know, I got to be honest.
Wait a minute, here's a cover and a count of two. Had a three.
I certainly hope that the World Wrestling Federation wins the Survivor Series. I certainly don't want to be out on the streets looking for a job. I don't want to be, you know, I'll be standing behind you at the unemployment line.
You and Trish. You and your good buddy.
Well, Trish has been very impressed with this week.
What a week she had.
Trish, you know, moves out from behind the desk on Excess and moves into the ring. Had a very impressive victory with Lita on Raw, and then a impressive one-on-one victory over Mighty Molly on SmackDown. And I don't know, maybe the time that she was out, she learned all those moves, because I've never seen those from her before, but very, very impressive. I'll call a spade a spade.
Yeah, very, very impressive, I know. And now with both Crash and Lance Storm down, referee Mike Sparks applying the count. We'll have highlights, of course, of so many things that happened in this past week, including The Rock challenging RVD for the hardcore title. Plus, what about what Shane and Stephanie did to their mother, Linda? You think you've seen the McMahon children sink to depths before? Well, after this past week, Coach, I don't think I could ever see them sink any lower.
And Shane and Stephanie, as they were leaving on SmackDown, you can see the look in their faces, KK. You can see the fact that Shane and Stephanie knew that they had done something wrong. When you grab your mother, when you slap your mother in the face, that is something you just don't do, period.
You got to wonder if they regret it. Will Vince McMahon make Shane McMahon pay for it this Monday on Raw in a street fight? Missile drop kick off the top rope. Is it enough?
What a huge victory this would be if Crash could defeat Lance Storm here on Metal.
Think about it. Shane and Vince McMahon met at WrestleMania, a WrestleMania rematch this Monday on Raw. What a super kick from Lance Storm. Is it enough? No, it's not. Wait a minute. Great play by Crash. As good a ring presence as Lance Storm is renowned for having, Crash equal to that task and was able to score a near fall. Oh, here we go. Hurricanrana. No, what a counter. Oh, Lance Storm. Pick him up tight in the single leg crab, and this one is over.
A tremendous counter by Lance Storm.
Survivor Series is going to be something else. It's all on the line, but still to come here on Metal. Tommy Dreamer teams with Mike Awesome to take on Albert and X-Pac.
But up next, highlights of that exciting U.S. title match between Kurt Angle and Christian. Coming up next.
Yeah. Well, Booker T scored a victory standing up. A little challenge laid down by Stone Cold Steve Austin, who showed tremendous leadership on behalf of the Alliance after being suspended, which I think more punishment than anything else for losing the U.S. title to Kurt Angle. What a tremendous title defense. What a matchup against Christian we just saw moments ago from SmackDown.
Well, Kurt Angle, night in and night out, never has a bad night. You know, Kurt Angle always brings it to the table. Kurt Angle, dare I say right now, is the World Wrestling Federation's MVP. And it just seems like right now Kurt Angle is a great champion, has turned into a great champion. And speaking of champions, you know, X-Pac is the light heavyweight champion, and it seems like no matter what X-Pac does, the crowd still chants
what they chant.
Exactly.
Free to express their opinion. That's one of the great things about the World Wrestling Federation fans. Tommy Dreamer, Mike Awesome, they make up a very impressive duo here to take on the team of X-Factor. And you have to know that as, well, I think mentally challenged as Mike Awesome can be, he is very physically gifted. I think Dreamer makes up more of that, you know, he's the brainy type, I think.
Certainly.
He's the one who can think up some bad stuff to do.
And by the way, I know last week you called him, you said that he wouldn't win any beauty contest.
That's true.
You said he's not pretty.
No.
You know, and that type of thing. And I heard through the grapevine that he wasn't exactly pleased with your commentary. You know, I said, you know, Kate Kelly calls it like Kate Kelly calls it.
Well, it's, you know, he's a good-looking man, I guess, in a rugged kind of street kind of way.
There,
how about that?
There we go. He'll probably be more happy about that.
Not bearing his midriff, though, as Chris Leary would be quick to point out.
Well, you know, you talk about guys that are in good shape. You talk about guys that are getting the job done. What about Booker T throwing his own tag team partner by the wayside, Test, to win that huge battle royal on SmackDown to get an opportunity to be a six-time WCW champion?
That title means everything.
Oh, look at Mike Awesome.
Oh, yeah.
You can't turn your head down when Albert's in the ring like that.
Man, what collisions we saw from one corner to the next, and you have to give it up for Booker T. You know, whether he turns on his partner, whether he takes advantage of an opportunity, however you want to look at it, that WCW championship means everything to Booker T. Wait a minute. Very impressive move there from Albert. Doesn't go for the cover and instead decides to tag in tag team partner X-Pac. We know, of course, that Jericho, very proud to hold that title. Booker T wants that title back in the worst way, but think about what Jericho also has as well. He has a rematch date sometime in the future against The Rock.
Well, Chris Jericho continue. Wow, what a clothesline by Mike Awesome. And when you talk about Chris Jericho and all the cocky statements he makes towards The Rock, he told Vince McMahon, hey, tell The Rock the champ says hello. You know, those things may come back to haunt Chris Jericho in the very, very near future.
Off the backbreaker, Tommy Dreamer gets a near fall on X-Pac, who's trying to build some momentum. You know, and I got to respect the leadership, the example set by Stone Cold Steve Austin. He was out one day, which was very understood, considering he had fought a tremendous matchup at No Mercy, survived 12 staples in his head, probably has a concussion, who knows. From there, one night away, the Alliance loses four titles. They come back the next night, and Austin lays down the gauntlet. Wait a minute, what a collision off the top. It would have been in, except for Albert. Think about it. Booker T stands up, finally takes a stand, wins the Battle Royal. And then, of course, setting up with RVD and The Rock, the Alliance did everything they could to derail the Great One.
Yeah, let's keep in mind that The Rock made it very clear he wasn't doing that for Mr. McMahon. He wasn't doing it for the benefit of Vince McMahon. The Rock was doing it because The Rock wanted to. The Rock was doing it because the World Wrestling Federation needed The Rock to take on RVD.
Dreamer runs right into the big clothesline.
And did you notice who came to, I hate to use the word rescue, but who came to the aid of The Rock on SmackDown?
Well, we'll show you those highlights, and you'll be able to see for yourself exactly who came to help out The Rock. We'll have those highlights for you coming up in moments. With now the team of, well, look at Mike Awesome and Tommy Dreamer missing with a double clothesline attempt, and Albert running right through the both of them.
I think that's an old offensive lineman.
From the University of Pittsburgh, that's right.
Type of move. I think it's an old offensive lineman type of move.
Yeah, well.
That's what I meant.
Hey, listen, Albert was a guy in the trenches, slugging it out for the Panthers.
Speaking of trenches, you know, Trish, oh, never mind. I never heard of
what
that.
What the heck are you talking about?
Oh,
hold on, Coach. The hands have been extended. Dreamer plus time. And Dreamer ain't going to get any better looking after the Waldo bomb.
That ain't right.
Here are your winners.
Still to come here on Metal. Speaking of tag teams, the former WCW tag team champions looking to rebound. The Hardys take on Hugh Morris and just incredible.
Yeah, but up next, the chase is on. But can Shane run forever? Take it out!
Oh, my gosh.
Next.
Well, I think that's something we can all relate to.
Well, I mean, who hasn't looked at other women? Especially Trish. I mean, come on. And week in and week out, I do it.
And Matt didn't exactly do anything wrong.
Shower with
her. Introducing first, from Pepper, North Carolina, at a combined weight of 441 pounds, the Hardy Boy.
Why wouldn't you want Lita and Trish in the shower together? That could
just leads to problems in and of itself. And, you know, hey, listen.
Listen, Matt Hardy's week did not improve last Thursday on SmackDown. They caught a tough break in a match with the Dudley Boys, and the WCW tag team titles were on the line. Matt gets distracted by Stacy, causing Jeff to get knocked off the top rope, and eventually 3D'd off the top rope. We've never seen that before. That gave the Dudleys the victory and the WCW tag team titles.
Well, you know, Stacy was sitting, you know, sticking her derriere in my face.
What do you mean, man?
Again and again and again and again.
Well, you know what? Listen, I take that all the way back to Stone Cold Steve Austin, laying down the gauntlet.
Yeah.
You know, and Alliance guys like the Dudleys really stepped up. And Stacy Keebler did her part. And that's why having her with the Dudleys makes the Dudleys a more effective unit.
Exactly. I know one guy that probably wouldn't look at Stacy's derriere.
Who's that?
Chris Leary.
What a shock. Hugh Morris is just incredible. Getting set to take on the Hardy Boys. You have to wonder what kind of negative momentum the Hardy Boys will be under here. You know, listen, you take a stinging loss on a Thursday night on SmackDown, and it takes a little bit of time to recover.
Yeah, certainly the Hardy Boys, like many of our champions and former champions, they take their titles very, very seriously. They've worked very, very hard to get to where they are now. And whenever you have a devastating loss like that, much like, you know, whenever a big-time college team has a big loss, say like Florida State, you know, when you lose to a North Carolina, to a team that you know you can beat, but you just didn't come quite good enough that particular night, get a little bit distracted.
Oh, yeah, 41-9, you were a little distracted. And then Miami a couple of weeks later,
I digress. I didn't want to bring that up.
Referee Charles Robinson trying to get in there and break it up, and just incredible, sees opportunity, capitalizes, drills. Matt Hardy, hard right hand. You know, we're a little disappointed with Matt, though, but I guess everything is okay.
Well,
no trouble in paradise.
You know, Matt's a two.
Exactly the right things to say. Lena, let's go down and take a shower.
Together.
Yes, that will always lose what little distraction may have been before.
And I'm sure if I was in Matt's shoes right there, I would want to take care of business as soon as possible. As far as mending the fences is what I'm talking about.
Hey, we got to send a shout out to The Rock. Not only did The Rock come within an eyelash of capturing the hardcore title, as we showed you just a little bit ago, but also The Rock, part of Entertainment Weekly's top 100.
The Mummy Returns. The Rock is The Rock. And look how far he's come in a very short period of time. It can be done, KK. And look at The Rock right now. I mean, he's a movie star. You know, he's a former WCW champion, WWF champion, a best-selling author. What hasn't The Rock done? And what hasn't The Rock done for the World Wrestling Federation? But think about this. If the Alliance wins at Survivor Series, The Rock is going to be out of the job.
Wow. You want to talk about high-priced, high-level free agents.
Wow.
They don't get any bigger than that. Could you imagine The Rock having to go to Shane and Stephanie and ask for a job?
You know, excuse me, Shane, Stephanie. The Rock is just thinking, if maybe you are doing it tonight, maybe you can have The Rock, the Brahma Bull, in the Alliance. I don't even think about it.
Beat it, they would say.
No, they would not. I doubt that.
Are you kidding me? They'd make The Rock's life miserable. They'll make all of our lives miserable. Jeff Hardy finally tagging. Just incredible. Oh, yeah, he's really going to pay for it. You know that the Hardy Boys, still smarting, as we mentioned, losing the WCW tag team titles Thursday on SmackDown. Hugh Morrison takes an arm drag. Jeff Hardy building some momentum.
Oh,
what a big, big clothesline.
That's what happens when you get distracted. That's what happens when you want to yell to the crowd instead of concentrating on your opponent. Florida State.
Ah, stop it.
Oh, sorry.
Come on, quit bringing that up. Jeff Hardy pays for some high risk. Just incredible with the referee's attention diverted. No, don't do it. The enormous barrel chest of Hugh Morris runs right into the midsection of Jeff Hardy.
Hugh Morris, although much slimmer than he used to be, is still a solid 280, 290, maybe 300 pounds.
Either way, could you imagine what Jeff Hardy was thinking when he's seeing a charging Hugh Morris coming at him in the corner? Nothing Jeff Hardy could do. His legs were tied up in the ropes. And now, Thanksgiving comes early. The wishbone on Jeff Hardy.
Jeff Hardy, make a wish.
Why am I laughing?
I don't know.
It's Jeff Hardy we're talking about.
We're not going to be laughing this Monday night. It's going to be all serious business.
Can you imagine what all the stops that Vince and Shane are going to pull out? We know how Shane, we've mentioned so many times, he's a big money player. Comes through in the pressure situations.
Yeah, I would think that he would come through on Monday night, but you got to wonder, how will Vince McMahon respond? You know, Vince McMahon hasn't been in the ring in a long, long time.
But
Shane has.
Vince did say Monday on Raw that he's taking some time off, and he says he's in the best shape of his life.
Well, either he's been working at home, either he's been working out. Whatever the case may be, Vince McMahon looks great, feels great, is back in the World Wrestling Federation to lead his troops. And I think that Monday night, he's going to get the job done against his son Shane.
Top rope, and now Jeff sees his opportunity, capitalizes, tag bang, big brother back. Head of steam now, off the ropes.
What a clothesline. You can tell Matt Hardy was just desperate to get in there against Justin Credible and Hugh Morris, KK.
Nice neck breaker now by Matt Hardy. We know, of course, that Vince and Shane will let it all hang out in the street fight this Monday on Raw. Hugh Morris makes a mistake, runs into the elbow. Matt Hardy, wait a minute now, tornado DDT. Nice. And now, Justin Credible into the corner. He's on the receiving end.
Has this turned into a handicap match?
Hey, listen, Jeff Hardy's recovering, and Matt is doing a great job. Can you imagine what... Imagine just being Matt Hardy's eyes, the way he was this past Monday on Raw.
Oh, yes. I'm thinking about it.
Even at No Mercy, he got an eye full of him. Stacey Keibler in her lingerie.
Yes.
I would love to be Matt Hardy. And especially now, look out! With the Kansas Jayhawk blue hair! Jeff Hardy flying over the top rope! Going for the twist of fate, but just incredible. Counters.
You son of a...
Almost running into referee Charles into the super kick! This will do it! Oh, why did he make a cover?
No cover. That could have been a huge loss for the Hardy Boys off their loss this past week.
Wait a minute. Look at the agility. Hugh Morris. Now, Matt, back on his feet. Twist of fate.
He nails it, KK. Nails the twist of fate.
Little brother Jeff. Volcano in his front yard. Swanton bomb. Two. Got it. Let's go to Chris Leary.
Hi, it's Chris Leary, and a reminder, WrestleMania 18 is happening. It's very soon. As a matter of fact, tickets go on sale next Saturday. And go to WrestleMania.com to see how you can be a big part of this. Well, speaking of pay-per-views, No Mercy was a huge success, and we want to thank all the people who went to WWF.com for the special webcast. One of the big matches you saw at No Mercy was Edge versus Christian in a ladder match for the Intercontinental title.
Christian hanging. Not a one-man concerto!